Before we get started, Sam Barton has an announcement to make. And I told him we'd make it at the beginning of the service. He's got this look like, I don't know. So let me whisper in his ear.
I just want to make sure all the committee chairpersons get their budget request in. The deadline is, I believe, the 24th of July. Because we're going to be making our budget for next year. And if you don't get them in, we get to determine it for you. So, yeah, make sure you get them in.
And don't forget, next Sunday, it'll look different in here. It'll look different in the fellowship hall. And because we're meeting with the Hispanic Church and with the Galilee Baptist Church next Sunday. So, and Sandy has an announcement.
Whatever you bring next Sunday, keep in mind, we have the warmer, but we do not have the stove or the oven. So we cannot keep anything hot or warm with that. And we usually use that. So as many cold things as you can bring or something that don't matter either way would be great. And it is just sides, dessert and sides.
Desserts and sides, okay. All right, anything else about that we need to discuss before we start our service today in worship, Lord? Dwayne says we need to turn it up, Ken. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Robert just told me they ordered the part that's supposed to be on Monday, so we may have none.
Yes. But we need
to count on it not happening.
So we need to count on it not happening. But if you forget, you bring it with, hopefully it'll work.
Okay. All right. Check to make sure you're on.
The green light was off, but it's on now. Okay.
Heard you real good.
Is that Pete sitting behind the pillar back there? Hey, brother. It's good to see you. I just want to make sure that this is going on and off, isn't it?
I just want to make sure it was you. It's hard to tell back there behind the thing. It's all.
It's all very fine. Okay. Got you in the pulpit.
Okay.
And hold it for a minute. Hold it for 2 seconds on until it gets energetic. Hold it after it gets green. Is it green?
Mm-hmm. It doesn't turn green until I take my thumb off of it.
Okay.
So, if it goes, just switch.
Okay. Because it's switching back and forth. But it's good to have y'all here today. We're going to begin our service today with a time of quiet meditation to the Lord, to think about Him, to dwell on Him, and to prepare our hearts to worship Him today. Dear Jesus, as we sit here in the quietness of this moment, as your spirit moves among us, we are reminded of the wonder and the awesomeness of our great God. The goodness and the kindness of our great God. And the joy and the peace that you give us. And we thank you, and we're here today to worship you in truth and in spirit because of all these things. So we bow humbly before your spirit that this might be a time of joy and praise in our great God. And may you be glorified and exalted in the process. In Jesus' name.
Good morning, everybody. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for being here with us today, and we ask for your presence as we worship you through song and in words, Father, and just continue to bless this service and bless everybody that is here today, Father. In Jesus' name, amen.
Today is Gratitude Sunday. It's the fifth Sunday of this month. In the months that we have fifth Sundays, we have a service of time of gratitude to the Lord. So the bulletin looks a little different this morning. We're going to read scripture, have a testimony, and we're going to sing. And gratefully and thankfully praise the Lord today. In Psalm 136, we read these words. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, to the God of gods, for his steadfast love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of lords, for his steadfast love endures forever. To him who alone does great wonders, for his steadfast love endures forever. Brother John Williams, who is here at our church and faithfully helps serve the church and all, is going to come and share gratitude to the Lord at this time. So, John, if you come.
I'm John, and I'm thankful today, and this testimony is for his glory. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the peoples. 1 Chronicles 16:8. So thank you, Jesus. You might know me as that guy that's in the finance office, or you might have heard rumors that the pastor jokes about somebody that works for Domino's Pizza. Well, that's me. There is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is a way of death. Proverbs 14:12. Today I'm grateful that I'm no longer an addict or an alcoholic, thanks to Jesus. Today I'm thankful that I no longer have to run and hide from everyone, because I knew that what I was doing was wrong. I'm grateful that when I was running as fast and as far away from God as I could, Jesus was there already. You see, I accepted Jesus as my Savior at an early age. I was baptized, a church member, and I listened to my grandmother. Then all of a sudden, I started enjoying what everybody else was doing, especially in high school and college, doing what seemed like fun. Instead of listening to my grandmother, I was going to show my grandmother that I was right. I went the wrong way, and the only way I could prove I was right was to continue in that way. potential turned into disappointment, and I was trapped. But it started with asking God, why do you let me keep doing this over and over again? And then there was a man that told me, God doesn't make junk. I am thankful that God placed people in my life to help me, to guide me, and that even though I didn't realize it at first, He was leading me down a path that was the best way for my life. Don't copy the behaviors and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Romans 12:2. Today I am thankful Jesus didn't let me go. Today I appreciate that I turned around with God's help. Today I am grateful I don't have to hide. I am thankful I don't have to run. Today I'm grateful my grandmother was right. Today I'm appreciative for what God is doing in my life. Today I'm grateful to know that Jesus is number one. In Jeremiah 9:24, God says, but let him who boasts, boast in this, that he understands and he knows me, that I am the Lord. Being grateful for my grandmother today, trying her best, as she told me on several occasions, don't be drunk, because that will ruin your life. Ephesians 5:18, New Living Translation, the rest of that verse says, instead, be filled with the Holy Spirit. Today I'm grateful for being in the way that Jesus wants me to go. Jesus says, apart from me, you can do nothing. John 15:5. Today I appreciate that life has not passed me by. I'm grateful to participate with the body of Christ on Sundays. Today I am thankful to be helpful to Sunset Park Baptist Church by paying bills and making reports. Today I'm grateful I can update the church website if needed. Today I appreciate Jesus for blessings received. Today I'm so thankful for the fresh package of grace this morning that I receive today, everything I need for today. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Today I am grateful to testify to what God is doing in my life. I appreciate knowing that I have done nothing, but God has done everything. For His glory, today I am grateful that He is not finished with you or me. As Paul says, being confident in this, he that began a good work in you will continue to completion until that day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. There's a song currently being played on the radio entitled Miracle Child, sung by Brandon Lake, that may say something like this. Jesus is the one who turns a dead-end story to a living, breathing testimony. The prodigal son has come home to Jesus where he's supposed to be. So let us celebrate Gratitude Sunday by thanking Jesus for all he has done in each of our lives. Quoting Luke 15:13, but it was fitting to celebrate and be glad because this brother of yours was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. Again, praise Jesus.
It's wonderful. Reason to praise the Lord this morning. If you'll stand with me, hymn number 44, For the Beauty of the Earth. This hymn just lists so many things that we have to be grateful for. We're not going to do all of those, but we're going to do verses 1, 3, 4, and 6, and I'll kind of remind you of those as we go. Would you stand?
Before I go much further and forget it, I would like to share that I'm thankful for Miss Peggy today.
Amen.
She is, y'all don't say that so hardly, okay? It's like y'all were waiting for that. But it is a joy to have you and being here today, and just thankful. And, you add a lot to the service when you're here worshiping with us. In Psalm 118, verse 1, it says, "Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his steadfast love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his steadfast love endures forever." At this time, our sister Frances Anderson is going to come and or stay there and share testimony with us. So
trust in the Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not on their own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. And in James 1:5-6, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally and unbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering, for that that waveth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. I have learned over the years that when adversity comes, God has tried to teach you something. I used to kind of jokingly say, "Okay, Lord, help me get this fast so I can get out of this." But you know, it seems like I would learn the first time, second time, third time. But in September, he put me flat. And I was unable to go do anything. Had an office with urines that was supposed to be coming up and all that. And I was flat. And when I say flat, I mean I didn't get out of bed. I thank God for Bill, who took care of me, nursed me. Did a lot of things that I would have never asked him to do for me. And as I was laying there, I was thankful for YouTube, which I've never spent that much time doing that kind of thing, but I've learned in the bed that that's a good tool. And about the same time, we had a brand new great grandchild. And I got this video from Adam. And he was sitting there at his piano. It was his turn to hold the baby. He was sitting there at his piano with the baby in one hand and his hands on the piano with the other, playing "This Is My Father's World." Been a long time since I heard that. And I looked up those words. There were many more blessings like that as I laid there. I'm a in-charge person, to my detriment and everybody else's, but God blessed our church, but he blessed me also when he brought John into our life. Back when we started Celebrate Calvary in 2010, John had been coming to our church for a while. He was running a recovery house. And when we started forming the team for Celebrate Recovery, the Lord led Hugh to Brother John to ask him to come be on the team because we felt like that he would give a lot of wisdom to what we were about to do. And so he was a great part of our team for the 10 years that we did this. We were going on 11 when we had to disband because of COVID. But I also knew John. I knew what a great guy he'd become. I knew the trip that he'd been on. I knew he was victorious. I knew what his skills were as he was going through college and the grades that he made, and it was in accounting. So he came in as doing that in our finance office just at the time that we lost the other person. We desperately needed somebody. And John was gifted in that, and I knew that he knew what he was doing. But I also would not necessarily turn loose of everything. I let him do, I mean, the computer was his. But, you know, I would still come in there every Monday and I would kind of go over the bills and everything. But then I would approve them and John would go on and he would pay them and enter them and all that. And then I went flat in bed. There was no coming up here on Monday afternoon telling John what to do. But I knew John could do it. I had faith that God had put him there for a reason and that I needed to just let him go and do it. John has done an absolutely great job. He's relieved a lot of the concerns off of me. But in the process of being on the Budget and Finance Committee, and that I always felt the burden of getting the bills paid and if the money was going to be enough and all these kinds of things. And the scripture says, trust in the Lord for all things. And I was blessed with being able to meet with Hugh on that afternoon. And money was not there, and we spread the bills out, and well, we didn't know the money was there. Money was not there as far as we knew, and we laid them out before him, we prayed, and listening to Hugh pray, there were times I prayed, but listening to him pray, my having to be responsible for it passed from my hands to the Lord. And such a blessing that by the time I was put flat, you know, and the first of me is, oh, woe is me, and it took me, I don't know, it was a couple weeks before I could ever even get to the computer. But the reason I was at the computer, and Ken kept me posted, Ken Butler kept me posted, the offerings poured in. Starting in September, and I was wondering what was going on. The Lord took me out, took Hugh out, took Lori out, all physical reasons. And I said, well, Lord, what are you doing? God was going to show himself mighty. And he did. We're not struggling, praise the Lord, to pay the bills. We all, and so far, whatever is goes out of the bank that week is put back in the bank in the offering on Sunday or comes in the mail. It's been an absolutely amazing. So what seemed to be adversity was such a blessing. I knew I could trust John. I was doing things I didn't have to do because John could do it. I trusted John. God put John there for a reason, and I needed to let go and let God do what God wanted to do. And I didn't have to do that anymore. Such a blessing. So many things I thought I had to do. God showed me I didn't have to do it, and to trust him. And I just praise the Lord. But I want to remind you of two things. Trust the Lord with all your heart. Not just what you won't turn loose of. Lean not on your understanding. You're not going to figure it out. God's got the plan. And then, what was the other one? My mind's going blank.
Lean not In all the ways acknowledge
him. In all the ways acknowledge him, he will direct your path. And then the other one was to trust him and not waver. An unstable man wavers. You know, I think I've got to do it the way I was taught to do it, because I was an accountant. But no, God's got, ultimately, this is God's business. He will lead, he'll provide, he'll undergird you. But he does require that we believe and trust are the same things, that God is who he said he is going to do what he said he was going to do. The promises are there. As his children, all we've got to do is trust in the Lord. And lean not on ourselves, but always acknowledge him.
Miss Peggy's going to come and lead us in the next hymn, but it's up the hymn of our invitation, and you just heard how God has blessed this church. And it doesn't take many people for God to bless, does it? Because we're not his resources. We're the funnel of his resources. He's the source of it all. And that's what you just heard. Conventional wisdom and man's wisdom says that we just need to shut the doors and go home. But that's not God's wisdom. And that's not faith. And that's not what he's about. And so you are hearing what God can do if we will trust him and obey him. And we're going to sing and worship him now with our tithes and our offerings. It's Gratitude Sunday. If you brought an extra offering, there's an extra offering envelope. Gratitude envelope in the pew. But this is a time of worship, and I believe that's one reason that God blesses us. We worship him by bringing it to the altar and laying it before him. So as Miss Peggy, if you'll come and lead us in the hymn, we'll worship the Lord.
It's hymn number 616, and it talks about trusting the Lord and trying the Lord, and he will prove his goodness to us. Would you stand?
Trust me.
Amen. Brother Sam.
Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this blessing that we have and the ability to be able to give our tithes and offerings, Father, and you know, the ability to give a little extra if we can, Father, and just continue to bless this that we have, that we may use it for your purpose, and that the finance committee may continue to have the guidance to use it as you want it to be used, Father. You've already got it in mind how you want it to be used. In Jesus' name, amen.
In Psalm 118, verse 21, it says, I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We have amongst us a brother, a deacon, who serves the Lord quietly, and he is a blessing to all that are around him. He's full of wisdom and knowledge. Comes from time he spends with the Lord in the Word, in prayer. And yet you've probably never heard him speak much. Brother Kenneth Carroll serves this church in many ways. If you come to the Wednesday morning Bible study, you will realize what a blessing he is. He's got so much knowledge about the Word of God that he keeps within himself. And he has a testimony of love for Jesus. And some of you have never heard his testimony. But I tell him all the time, write it down because it's got to come out, brother. And our testimony should just, we just ought to, our bones burn within us to share about how good Jesus is. So Brother Kenneth wrote out a short testimony of his thankfulness to the Lord, and I'd like to read it for him today. But before I do that, Kenneth, I'm not going to ask you to stand, but some people may not know who you are. Will you just wave? Okay, this is Brother Kenneth Carroll, okay? I would like to thank the church for the prayers, visits, and card and food during my illness. 2024 has been a difficult year. God daily met each need as it appeared in my life. God has given me the strength that I needed each day for that day. March the 5th started out like an ordinary day. I went to Hardy's that morning for the men's Bible study. That night I went to the Baptist men's meeting, and I needed a wheelchair to get into the fellowship hall. And what he means by that is he got here but couldn't get out of the car. Okay. Later that night, I fell out of bed and I was in the hospital before the sun came up. I found out that I had the flu and a fever. I remained in the hospital until March 11th. I left the hospital for therapy at Peak Resources, and finally on March 28th, I came home in a very weak condition. With God's help, I have gained some of my strength and weight back. He used WellCare Home Care to supply the help which I needed throughout this time. It has been a long, slow process. But God is healing me, one day at a time. Each day he supplies the grace that I need for that day. I have many health issues with which I must deal, diabetes, high blood pressure, and Parkinson's disease. But each day, I am convinced God is not finished with me and has more for me to accomplish in His kingdom. Amen. Thank you, Brother Kim.
A Sunday school teacher once, he said, we get so overwhelmed with our problems and our issues that might be facing us that we forget to count our blessings. And he challenged the class, just take a piece of paper and write down your blessings, things you can be thankful for, and I guarantee you it will way outweigh those problems that you're dealing with. That's what we're hearing this morning. That's what we're hearing. Count Your Blessings, hymn 644. If you can stand, we're going to sing verses 1 and 4.
Sacrifice with cords up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, I will extol you. I'll give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His steadfast love endures forever. Our sister Hope Foles will now share a gratitude testimony for gratitude to the Lord. She sings after you.
Okay, you say something.
Right,
Just in case you don't know me, I'm Hope Falls, Hugh's wife. When I was a child, I hated going to church. But a lot of it, looking back on it later, a lot of it was because of my